Good evening. Welcome to St. Robert's Parish. At this time of the year, when the days grow shorter and the weather turns colder, we are faced with readings that point to the end of times. As we pay close attention to the readings and join in prayer during this liturgy, let us recall Jesus' promise to protect all those who trust in his name. Our gathering name is Jerusalem, my happy home, number 888 that we celebrate the Lord. Please stand as we begin our celebration.
Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, A reading from the book of the prophet Malachi. Lo, the day is coming, blazing like an oven, when all the proud and all evildoers will stumble, and the day that is coming will set them on fire, leaving them neither root nor branch, says the Lord of hosts. But for you who fear my name, there will rise the Sun of Justice with its healing rays. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial song can be found in the Missalette on page 84.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, you know how one must imitate us, for we did not act in a disorderly way among you, nor did we eat food received free from anyone. On the contrary, in toil and drudgery, night and day, we worked so as not to burden any of you. Not that we have to do the right, rather, we wanted to present ourselves as a model for you, so that you might imitate us. In fact, when we were with you, we instructed you that if anyone wasn't willing to work, neither should that one eat. We hear that some are conducting themselves among you in a disorderly way, by not keeping busy, but minding the business of others. Such people we instruct and urge in the Lord Jesus Christ to work quietly and to eat their own food. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
people were speaking about how the temple was adorned with costly stones and votive offerings, Jesus said, "All that you see here, the days will come when there will not be left a stone upon another stone that will not be thrown down." Then they asked him, "Teacher, when will this happen? And what sign will there be when all these things are about to happen?" He answered, "See that you not be deceived. For many will come in my name, saying, 'I am he,' and 'the time has come.' Do not follow them. When you hear of wars and insurrections, do not be terrified, for such things must happen first, but it will not immediately be the end." Then he said to them, "Nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be powerful earthquakes, famines, and plagues from place to place, and awesome sights and mighty signs will come from the sky. Before all this happens, however, they will seize and persecute you. They will hand you over to the synagogues and to prisons, and they will have you led before kings and governors because of my name. It will lead to your giving testimony. Remember, you are not to prepare your defense beforehand, for I myself shall give you a wisdom in speaking that all your adversaries will be powerless to resist or refute. You will even be handed over by parents, brothers, relatives, and friends, and they will put some of you to death. You will be hated by all because of my name, but not a hair on your head will be destroyed. By your perseverance, you will secure your lives." The Gospel of the Lord. Friends, before we come to the conclusion of the liturgical year, which is next weekend, when we celebrate the solemnity of the feast of Jesus Christ, the King of the universe, the readings for this particular time, I said a couple weeks ago, you'll begin to see a shift in the readings at this particular time of the year, which focus our attention on the end times, as we hear in the scriptures for today, particularly the gospel. We're talking about what the Lord said before the end comes. You will hear people predicting, "I am he, the time has come. Do not follow them." And sometimes you hear people saying and predicting, which they have for years now, Nostradamus, and so forth and so on, they're predicting when the end of the world is going to come. They even put a time and a date. It's going to be March such and such. It never came. Do not follow them. That's what we are told by Jesus himself in today's gospel. Oh yes, you're going to experience and see wars. Aren't we seeing wars? How many times people are talking when there's earthquakes and we see all these hurricanes and everything else is the full moon was just out, the lunar eclipse, and so forth and so on, the blood moon, and everybody's beginning to question and wonder all kinds of things. There's going to be plagues and famines. You're going to experience all these things, and mighty signs will come from the sky, meteors, and all these other things that we hear about and so forth and so on. Before all this happens, however, we will experience even suffering within our own lives. A couple weeks ago, we heard about the Beatitudes on the feast of the Holy Day of All the Saints. Blessed are you when they persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. And Jesus brings that out in today's gospel. The last line is what is important. Not a hair on your head will be destroyed. There's nothing to fear. There's nothing to be afraid of. But by your perseverance, you will secure your lives. And so some may say, this is fire and brimstone, and so forth. Well, maybe it is. Maybe it does catch our attention, and maybe it should. Because again, as the liturgical year is coming to an end, and then we'll begin the season of Advent in preparation for Christmas, and we're going to start all over again. The whole cycle of life starts all over again. And then a new year will come, and everything that we will experience goes along. By your perseverance, you will secure your lives. Don't be afraid. There's nothing to fear. As long as we have God, and as long as we have the faith to believe in God who is with us. And so as we listen to these readings, and as we pray on them and reflect on them for our own lives, let us continue to go forward and persevering to secure our lives so that when the Lord should call, we're ready to go. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, the God from the true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial of our Father. For him all things were made. For us, trusting in God who protects the threatened. exalts the suffering, we call to mind the needs of the world.
Our response today is, Lord, hear our prayer. For the Church, that we may be faithful to our mission to bring Christ to others as a sign of justice in times of persecution and hope in times of despair. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That leaders around the world may respond wisely to the signs of danger to the Earth's climate by working together to prevent greater death and destruction. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are incarcerated, both guilty and innocent, especially those on death row, that they might find mercy and peace during their time in prison. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all our prayers, spoken and unspoken, for the sick and homebound, and for all those in our special intention book, Hear Our Cross, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That as winter approaches, those who are homeless or who are unable to afford warm clothes or shelter may be protected from the debilitating cold. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are unable to join the Eucharist in person, that they may realize their connection to all the faithful who come together to give thanks to God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in Christ, for John Rowlands, for whom this Mass is being offered, and for all the deceased who are listed on the envelopes here on the altar, and for others we would like to remember, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On this World Day of the Poor, which Pope Francis has declared this particular Sunday, we give our stewardship of time, treasure, and talent as we seek to serve God's people, especially the poor and those who are in need. Hear these prayers through Christ our Lord.
During the presentation of gifts, the instruments team, be not afraid. Number 882, we celebrate.
Thank you.
brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the cause of the Holy Church.
Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we, what we offer in the sight of your majesty, may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you, and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed us in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder to rule in your name over all and with name, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so, with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Thank you.
offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Joseph, our Bishop, all the clergy, religious, and faithful people. Remember John Rowlands, also our brothers and sisters, the souls of the faithful departed who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her beloved spouse, the blessed apostles, all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
During communion, please join in singing, "To Be Your Bread," number 26, "Live and Serve."
Body Christ. Body Christ. Body Christ.
Lord, I love you.
may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord. Just a few things before you go. Tomorrow, the Holy Name Society is having a spaghetti and meatball dinner, so it's a good dinner. You won't have to cook. You can come right over to the school cafeteria and have that delicious spaghetti and meatball dinner, or you can take it out, either or. Also, the Christmas wreaths are on sale. They're a little behind of what we normally have at this time, so if you want the Christmas wreaths, you better sign up for them soon. Again, the ladies' altar and rosary raffle tickets. Again, we ask you to get those in, as well as the annual appeal. We're over halfway of the goal, so we have a big ways to go. I know I can count on you. We always go over the goal, so I look forward to you giving to the annual appeal so that we make our goal. And today, on this World Day of the Poor, we recognize that our generosity to these things is to help those who are less fortunate, especially the poor. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Have a good evening. Be careful now. It's dark out there, so be careful.
Please join us in your recessional hymn, number 791, We Are the